For those of you who don't know, I'm Maggie, and I am so excited that it is finally spring. I feel like this year, especially in Dallas, we went through kind of a crazier winter than we usually do. So I wanted to spend some time going around my house, gathering up things that I use over and over again in the spring and the summer. Now, for us, we don't really get a spring in Texas. It's like you get a good 3 weeks of like this really nice weather, and then all of a sudden it's like 90 degrees and you don't even know how it happened. So that's why I'm looping this in with spring and summer, because these items can kind of help transition you between seasons if you were like me and maybe don't really have much of a spring. Or if you do, maybe it'll give you time to stock up for summertime. I don't know. But these are all definitely hot weather related items that are in the clothing space. We've got some beauty things, we've got some accessories, so let's dive right in. The first thing is some type of BB cream or CC cream. I'm not somebody that wears foundation on a regular basis. I don't love high coverage things in general. I want something that looks like skin. It looks really natural. It's easy to put on. I definitely prefer to put on BB creams, CC creams, or any face products with my hands. I don't want to bother with wetting sponges or cleaning off brushes routinely. All right, so my two favorites in this space both come from Amazon. This one is the Misha Perfect Cover BB Cream. This one's in the shade number 23, and that's what I'm wearing today. Even though this is kind of like their third darkest shade, these tend to really blend into your skin, and you can be like a wide range of skin tones and have these different things work for you. I don't know if I'm explaining that well, but it goes on in kind of a darker gray tan color that you're like, whoa, this does not match me at all. But seriously, continue to spread it out and it will just match your face perfectly. So that's what I'm wearing. But then this one is one that was recently introduced to me through Jessica Braun here on YouTube. And this is the Purito Cica Clearing BB Cream. And I also got this one in the shade number 23 because she talked about how similar these are. And I think overall, these are super duper similar. They're both super breathable. They don't give you like super high coverage. They're easily applied and spread out with your hands. But I would say that the Misha one is a little bit more forgiving. I think that the pigment in this one is a little deeper. I think that this gives maybe even a little bit more coverage because I say this, because I just kind of like messily put it all over my face, and you could definitely see streaks of like darker color on my neck where I hadn't blended well. And I don't think that I've ever run into that with the Misha one. Not to deter you from this, because I still think this is awesome and almost gives you a more foundation-like look. So if that's what you're into, but you also want the added benefits of the good skincare and stuff that's oftentimes found in BB cream and CC cream, you would probably want to go with the Purito one if you like that extra coverage. Neither of them have fragrance. They're both really easy to apply and put on. These are around the same price. I want to say I usually pay anywhere from $7 to $10 for these on Amazon. So even though those BB creams and CC creams that we just talked about come with an SPF, I always include some sort of additional SPF in its pure form all over my face before I put that BB cream or CC cream on. Now, two of my favorites both happen to come from Paula's Choice. These are both the full size product and they're in such different tubes. It looks kind of strange, but this one I've been using for years. This is the Paula's Choice Super Light Daily Wrinkle Defense with Broad Spectrum SPF 30. This one is a little bit tinted, but I hesitate even telling you that because it truly doesn't give you much coverage. Now, sometimes I will put this on and I do think it can even out your skin tone just a touch. This says it's for all skin types, normal, oily, and combination. And I think in general, it does dry down to more of a matte finish. So you have to think about that and think about if that's your preference. And I always have to pair this with an additional moisturizer. I can't get away with just putting this on my face, but this I really love, layers great under makeup and dries down really quickly. But another one that I recently discovered that's been wonderful during the winter to give me just like a little bit more life and a little bit more of a glow is this Paula's Choice Defense Essential Glow Moisturizer. This also has broad spectrum SPF 30. It instantly illuminates and hydrates, reinforces what makes skin naturally healthy, and is a replenishing cream texture. To me, this has the exact same texture of any sort of luminous primer. So with this, I don't necessarily feel like I need an additional moisturizer with it, but I do typically use that anyway. But just know you could get away with it. And this I recently mentioned in a product empties and how I can't wait to travel with this because it's a one-stop shop. You've got this moisturizing quality, SPF, this luminous primer quality to it. I love this. And it's 2 fluid ounces, so it can totally go on your carry-on on the airplane because it doesn't exceed that 3 ounce threshold. Both of these can, actually. They're both 2 fluid ounces. Now, if you're like, okay, both of those sound great, how do I decide which one? Well, if you have more oily skin in the summertime and the springtime, I would say go with this one, the Super Light Daily Wrinkle Defense. It's a little bit more mattifying and won't contribute to an overly oily look. But if you have somebody with drier skin year round, then I think you would really, really like this. Even if you're oily though, and I would definitely say that I'm an oily skin person in the spring and the summer, you could put a powder over this and it would just look good and healthy. So don't be afraid of this. If you do have oily skin, I still think you could use it. But if you're trying to choose between the two, that would be my suggestion. All right, and my skin tone is just about as pale as they come. This is me with some self-tanner on and also a big light right here. So maybe it's washing me out a little bit. But I have really been enjoying Tanceuticals. Got this last year and I have about a half bottle left. And this is their CC, which stands for Color and Correct Self-Tanning Body Lotion. And I have mine in light because I'm not trying to go from like snow white to like super tan model on the beach, because that would just be shocking and people would be like, wow, she really self-tanned. So this is a lot more subtle for me, but I don't know. I think it looks nice. I think it just gives me kind of a healthy glow. It goes on so easily. And the thing that I really like about this is that it comes with a mitt. And so you can really evenly apply the lotion. And how I like to do it is I will shave my legs the day before I go to use this so that everything is really, you know, exfoliated. And then I'll put this on right out of the shower, let it dry for a little bit, get dressed, and then go to sleep that night. It does not transfer to your sheets. And we have like pure white bedding, as you can see, which I was very concerned about. It was definitely a risk when I did it for the first time, but it did not transfer at all. And you wake up the next morning and you are instantly just glowy and a little bit more tanned. So if you have been really nervous to try tanning products, this one I would highly recommend, coming from a tanning chicken myself. I don't do spray tans, I don't do any of that. And this stuff is very approachable, very easy to use, especially with that mitt. They say to make this last the longest is that every day you really want to be moisturized so that your skin's not dry and flaking and you're kind of losing some of that color. And as long as you stay moisturized, I think that this can last you pretty much a full week. In the springtime, especially when I haven't seen the sun for a while and I'm really ready to wear shorts and tank tops and stuff like that, this just gives me a little bit more confidence that you're not seeing my veins and bones inside because of how translucent I am. So really, really like this Tanceutical stuff. Like we just talked about, you have to be moisturized in order to make that self-tanner last the longest extent possible. One way that I've been doing that is with this lotion that I love. And this is huge because I really hate lotions in general. I will have dry, cracking knuckles for the longest time because I hate putting lotion on my hands. But this stuff allows you to put lotion on your hands and not be a greasy mess to where you can't open things or touch things without grease getting everywhere. And in the summertime, after you've spent a ton of time in the sun, even if it's not related to tanning products, it's really great to replenish your skin, moisturize afterwards. So this is the La Roche-Posay Extra Dry Skin Body and Face Lipicar Balm. It's an intense repair moisturizing cream, and it's supposed to give you up to 48-hour hydration. I typically like to take a shower and put this on all over my body, and I'm a night showerer, so then I sleep and wake up and I'm still fully moisturized. This has such a good, thick formula that also leaves a little bit of like, do you see that sheen and luminosity on my skin? That's from this. It really helps you look healthy and moisturized, and your skin looks really supple. It has done a great job of kind of extending the life of that self-tanner. Now, I'm very diligent around like joints like my elbows and my wrists and my hands and my feet and stuff, where self-tanner can oftentimes look a little wonky. This has been great. This is kind of pricey though. I want to say this bottle was like $20. Lotion's one of those things that tends to last me forever, so I honestly don't mind paying a little bit more for it if it truly is delivering that all day or all 2 day, as it's claiming, moisture. And this one really does lock it in and make your skin just look so healthy and glowing. So I think that this is a great summer, spring lotion to turn to. Some Skylar perfumes. I know I talk Skylar perfumes to death on this channel, but I love them. Legitimately, with the exception of one, the Glossier You perfume, I own exclusively Skylar perfumes because they're hypoallergenic, cruelty-free, a little bit better for you. You're not just spraying harsh chemicals in your skin and letting it absorb. It lasts on your skin, especially these two scents. And these are my favorite for the spring and summertime. The first one is Salt Air. This one is extremely beachy. Like, you smell like you are standing on the edge of the ocean, not in a salty way, but more in just like a fresh, crisp air way. And then Sunshower, on the other hand, is the ultimate springy scent. This is so fresh and bright and energizing, and honestly, my favorite thing to do is to layer these on top of each other. So I do a couple of spritzes of each and mix them together. In fact, I haven't worn these two separately from one another in a really long time because I like that combo so much. So these are available at all times. They're part of their permanent line. These bottles each retail for $78, but I feel like any full-size perfume in general is that, if not more. So, I mean, I think perfume is just an expensive commodity in general. So totally worth it if you're looking for that perfect spring and summer scent. All right, moving on to some hair care. One thing that I really struggle with in the summertime is frizzy hair because things can get really humid here in Dallas. It still takes a toll on your hair and all the little flyaways are like sticking up on the top. And I feel like that happens every single time that I blow dry my hair. Well, enter these products right here. So these all come from Eva NYC and these were sent to me for review purposes through Octoly, but the cool thing about that site, if you've never heard of it, is that I have the option to go on and actually pick out the products. So this isn't something that just was sent to me and they told me to say good things. No, this is something where I went on and intentionally picked this out because I thought these products sounded like something that would be perfect for my particular hair situation. Okay, so these are from Eva NYC. Already mentioned that, but these are the Satin Dream Smoothing Shampoo Leave-In Cream. So this is kind of after you get out of the shower, and the conditioner. Love the pump style bottles and the fact that these are different colors so that you can actually tell them apart. My issue is, for some reason, this one will not pop up. So I've got to do some surgery on this and make this pop up to work. But these are extremely moisturizing. I can't use these all the time because these will make my scalp really greasy over time. But if you know that you're gonna go be in the sun for a long time or you're gonna do a lot of heat styling on your hair and you tend to get those little flyaways and frizzies, like that little halo of frizz that sits above your head, this would be perfect for you. Or if you just have, in general, like super dry hair, look no further. So these claim to smooth, fight frizz, and they're anti-humidity, and I totally believe that because the first time I used this, I was like, whoa, this stuff is really thick. And I'm somebody who can't use conditioner on the top of my head because I do have a scalp that tends to get really greasy. So I would say if you are super prone to greasy hair, this is not gonna be the stuff for you. But maybe you're somebody who treats your hair really harshly and you just need that added drink of moisture, this is gonna be perfect for you. This also has no sulfates, no parabens, no phthalates, it's vegan, it's cruelty-free, and these bottles are 100% recyclable. Like, they're these really sturdy metal bottles. The scent, they're saying, it's powered by poppy seed and snow mushroom. This is a very woodsy scent. Not at all what I was expecting based on just like the color of the bottles and the overall vibe here. I honestly wouldn't say that the scent is the standout quality of these products. It's legitimately how well they fight frizz and smooth your hair. So next up, let's talk about a couple of accessories. I'm not gonna beat this one to death because I've talked about them a million times, but it's these little kind of octagon shaped sunglasses. Got these on Amazon for something like, I don't know, $8 to $10 or something. Now I will say these are exactly what you pay for because this is actually the second pair of these that I've owned. I traveled with these to Greece, the original pair, and the like black coating or whatever on the lenses started to peel off with all of the, I guess, exposure to salt and air and beachy kind of conditions. So just be aware of that. They're very lightweight because sometimes glasses can be bothersome for me, and I love that they're lightweight. I really like the unique shape. They're super accessible and affordable, and they do a great job of blacking out the sun. Like, they have really dark lenses. I look for that in sunglasses. I don't like the super light tinted sunglasses because I have very sensitive eyes when it comes to the sun. So these were big old winners and look just like the Ray-Ban versions of these. Another accessory I love for so many reasons is this purse from the brand called Dagny Dover. I love this little pop of blue and wanted to bring it up for this reason. I typically carry some sort of like brown or black purse throughout the year, but in the spring and summer, especially if I'm going to dinner or some sort of event or something, I like to add a little pop of color that's still kind of a neutral. This is also my very favorite travel purse because it comes with its own duster bag. I love that this this can be cross-body, so you always feel like it's close to you and safe and you have control over it when you're in kind of a new place. And it's the perfect size. Some people may consider this too small. So if you feel like you're that person, you may want to get the bigger version of this because they do sell that as well. But it has its own little lipstick holder so you can put your chapstick or lipstick or whatever you want to take with you that day. It fits your phone, it fits a wallet, and that's pretty much all I want to carry around. If you don't want to put your separate wallet in there, it also has these little easy access card slots, which I really like. Very high quality. I love a ton of the Dagny Dover products. I have like a travel wallet. My everyday wallet is from this brand. And they really do hold up over time. They're a little bit pricey, but I think totally worth it. And another cool thing about this bag is you can take the straps off and it is designed to be a clutch as well. So if you wanted to use it like that, if you're a clutch person, check it out if you've been in the market for a cutie little travel purse. Sticking with accessories, Brian's probably gonna overhear me and laugh, but I'm trying to become a hat person. I find so much value in them, but I'm always so nervous to wear hats. And I don't know why, I just feel like I'm gonna look ridiculous, but this is one that I purchased last summer at the very end of summer. So I didn't even get to put it to use, but I'm really excited to put it to use this year. And it's just this cute little kind of wider brimmed fedora. Now I have mine in this lighter white color with the black band, but I purchased this on Amazon and it comes in so many different colors. They also have different details that kind of go around the top of the hat. And the inside is adjustable. So if you have a smaller head like me, I've pulled this a little bit, but on the whole, this fit really well. It says that this is 56 to 58 centimeters in girth here. I think that this is just gonna be so nice to use at the pool or at the beach this summer, just to keep the sun out of your face, try to limit the amount of exposure that you're getting while still looking stylish, keeping your crazy windblown hair at bay. At first I was nervous. I was like, how am I gonna travel with this? But I've read all of these different packing techniques where you can put this in your suitcase like this and fill it with socks or underwear or bathing suits all rolled up inside so that it keeps its structure, but you're still packing and using that space effectively, which I thought was really nice. So whenever we go on our honeymoon later this year, I'll have to do a little packing video to show you like if this works or not. And I have another hat on the way too that if I like a lot, I'll have to show you in a different video, but I couldn't go without mentioning this. It's something inexpensive, like $16 to $18, and it is pretty high quality. So in the spring and summer, I wear basically two styles of sandals. I have this little open slide type, but then I also wanted to mention these Huarache sandals from Nisolo. These are real leather, handmade, very high quality, and ultra comfortable. I'm somebody that can't have my toenails painted all the time. Like my toenails just can't tolerate it. They get this weird stuff on them. And so I have to routinely take my toenail polish off. And during those times, I don't want my naked toes out in the world. And so this is the perfect answer. These are so comfortable, match so many outfits, and have been a great transition shoe from like the colder winter weather into spring. These come in a variety of colors. I have mine in the almond is what this is called, but they also have it in a white and a darker brown if maybe you already kind of have shoes in this color. These do have a small little break-in period. I would say the first two times that I wore them, they rubbed a little bit on the back, and since then, I can wear these all day for hours, walking miles with no issue whatsoever. They do stretch a little bit over time, but just like all knee solo shoes, let me make sure. I usually get a 7.5 in all knee solo shoes, and I'm typically a size 7. So I go up a half size, if that's helpful for you in sizing it all. But these are so cute, very classic, and have lasted me. This will be my third year with these shoes. In the spring and the summer, I don't like to wear athletic clothes all the time. Now, I wear them like 99% of the time, but blue jean shorts are a huge staple in my spring and summer wardrobe. And my very favorite shorts come from Old Navy. I have three pair, they're all denim, because they genuinely make the most comfortable and flattering denim shorts. So the first pair that I ever owned were these. They're like a little bit distressed at the top. These are the boyfriend style jean, and I believe I have mine in a size 0 regular. Yep, and these seriously are the perfect amount of blousey at the bottom so they don't hug your thighs. They're not super duper short. I think these are in a 3.5 inch inseam, if I'm not mistaken. I travel with these every time, and people are like, you wear denim shorts to travel? And I'm like, yes, because these are so comfortable. I've also worn these a million times and the denim is getting super duper soft. And I love the wash of this because this is just a very like classic, matches everything kind of denim color. The second pair that I got were these white shorts. I had some kind of like chino style white shorts, but I wasn't always going for like that tailored of a look. And so I thought this was a great answer. These don't have any sort of distressing. These are just basic white jeans. And these are in the exact same style, that boyfriend style from Old Navy. I also have these in a zero, so sizing is pretty consistent. And I like the rolled hem feature on both of these styles of shorts. But I did pick up one more pair this season that's super unique in that it's high-waisted and it has this little buttonfly closure. So I also liked the lighter wash denim. Again, it still has that rolled hem, but these are the same like 3.5 inch inseam. They just have like a taller waist. So these are super flattering, another great versatile color. And I feel like the high waisted will make it really cute to kind of like tuck things in the front and pair with different outfits. So if you're looking for super comfortable jean shorts, look no further than Old Navy. They're extremely affordable. These, I think, were somewhere around the $15 mark. I also got these in a size zero, and these are the high-rise secret slim pocket denim. But like I mentioned with everything else, it's all linked down below. Another recent find is this bathing suit cover-up. I also got this one from Amazon and love this little detail. It is cut out, so it's still breezy and stuff, even though it's like a long sleeve cover-up, but it has these kind of like flared out arms. It's really blousey, and because it's completely button-up closure, you can wear this in a variety of ways. Because I'm so short, it does come to like mid-thigh on me, so it could work out as a bathing suit cover-up kind of long dress shirt, or you can unbutton this and pair it with maybe those blue jean shorts with your bathing suit top or something. This is just a little bit more versatile, can make it look like you're wearing a different bathing suit cover-up even though you're not. And the white is just an easy throw on, great spring and summer color. And I just liked how it was a little bit unique with this little open, I don't know what you call this, like embellishment detail on this cover up. And I think this is one size, if I'm not mistaken. But if it's not, I probably got this in a small. There's just no tag on it. These are the last two things that I want to mention today, and they also come from Amazon. And it is these little workout tops. Now these you can throw on with leggings or something and just wear as like a little crop top around town if you wanted to. Tie a little sweatshirt around your waist if you're weird about the midriff showing. But this one in particular is so buttery soft and is said to be a dupe for the Lululemon Align tank. Now I don't own that, so I honestly can't tell you if it's the same or not, but I love the built-in pads here. The inner part of this is a bra top. You can remove the pads if you want to, if you're somebody that doesn't like to have that additional coverage, but for me it totally works. Love this little icy blue color, and I'm considering getting this in a white to wear under kind of like see-through shirts. Anywhere where you would wear a camisole, you could wear this instead, because this is so comfortable and so soft. Whew, this is a really, really good find. Along the same vein, I also got two of these tops. One of them is dirty right now, but I got it in this blue color and then also in kind of a pink color. These were great and did a good job of not showing my sweat very much when I exercised. These also have pads and this built-in bra top, and I loved just the little spaghetti strap, very basic kind of detail on these. It's a super flattering fit, especially if you wear this with maybe some high-waisted leggings or something to exercise in. I think this pandemic has made it really, really hard for me to wear a traditional bra. I find them very, very uncomfortable now. And so this could also be something that you wear under a t-shirt or something, because it does fit pretty tight to your body. So if you like kind of a long line sports bra, you could wear this every day as well, because again, this doesn't suck you in too much. It's super comfortable. So these I just feel like are all around really versatile tops, not just something that you can work out in. They both come in a variety of colors. They have some basic like whites and blacks, but they also have more fun colors like these blues, reds, wine colors. They truly have a color for everybody. That is everything. That is all of my spring and summer essentials, some of the favorite items that I like to go to during these hotter months. And if you have any suggestions or questions about anything that I talked about today, please let me know. I'd love to chat with you about it in the comments. And if you like this video, then like it. Stick around, subscribe, join the community, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.